Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So here is the best and worst list of skincare in 2020. Now these are not necessarily new launches which have launched in 2020 because I didn't get a chance to try a lot of things, but these are things which I've thoroughly enjoyed throughout 2020. So these are products I've always reached out to. So that's going to be the pattern. If you expected these to be new launches, then they're very less new launches which I'm talking about. But I'm generally talking about products which I've reached out a lot and which are my favorites of 2020. Anyway, getting that out of the way, one more thing is all these products work from me and it might not work for you. So if there's a product I really like and you don't really like, that's completely fine. And there's a product I really don't like and you really like, that is also completely fine. Everybody has different taste and everybody has different skin. So now let's get started with the video. Okay, I'm not going to show you all the products in my hand. By the way, I'll pop a picture because it gets too much to put everything back in its own place. I'm tired of cleaning every single day, so please spare with me. I don't want to bring everything again, put it back in place. It's too much work. So I'll just pop on some picture here and talk about the product. So this is my best and worst video for skincare. The next one is going to be the best and worst for makeup. So subscribe and ring the notification bell if you haven't already. So the first one, we are going to talk about is, I don't have any order of drugstore high end. I just wrote down a lot of products which I have been reaching out and I'm just going to tell you what they are. So the first one is a moisturizer, Clinique Moisture Surge. Absolutely love it. It has become one of my favorites. I actually ignored that moisturizer for a lot of time. I don't know, I was it's fine, but I feel that fine only was it was what I needed when my skin was in a very bad condition. It just needed a moisturizer which moisturizes it and doesn't do any harm. So Clinique Moisturizer, I've been reaching out so much for it and I really like it. The next one is Sugandha White Lotus Moisturizer, another favorite, the unscented version. They've released unscented versions of all the products they have now. So I've tried the unscented version and I really like it. It's a very good moisturizer for oily skin. If you have dry skin, it won't be enough, but it's really good for oily skin and it does the job. It doesn't make you feel greasy. It gets absorbed really well and keeps the hydration intact. The next one is, this is a new favorite which I've actually been just using since the past 45-ish days. So this is the Olay Retinol Moisturizer. This particular one I just have right by me, so I just grabbed it. So it's a very creamy consistency, but it's a water cream. It is not too heavy. Now anything in this video, nothing is sponsored, you guys. So even if it's cream, you blend it out and it's like a water cream type of formula. It has a little bit of retinol in it. So if you're somebody looking for to start off with retinol, then you can definitely buy this one. Now this is not a day moisturizer, it's only a night moisturizer. So you can buy this for start adding this retinol into your skincare slowly and gradually, and then you can shift to serums, etc. It is fragrance free. So one more really amazing point. Then the next moisturizer I absolutely love is the Mamaearth Apple Cider Vinegar Moisturizer. I really like it. I've been using it for since last year, and this year I've used so many tubes so many times and I really really like this one. That's one of the moisturizers I bought, I think repurchased it 3 to 4 times till now, and I really like it. It's good for sensitive skin, acne prone skin, oily skin also. It's a cream, it's a thick one, but if you're extremely oily it might be heavy, but if you're normal dry skin to semi oily, it would perfectly suit you, and it's non-comedogenic, and that is yay. Next one is a lip balm, Organic Harvest Lip Balm. It has shea butter in it and it is a very waxy thick type of lip balm. So if you like such types of lip balm, then you'll definitely like this. But if you're somebody who just wants it to be very lightweight, then you will not like this. I really like this because once you apply it, because it's very waxy and very thick, it stays on the lips and it doesn't move. Even if you apply in the night, in the morning you wake up, you still have that film type of thing on your lips, which puts all the moisture intact and hydrates it. So that's the reason I really like this lip balm. Again, I've bought this over 5 to 6 times till now because it gets over every month. So lip balms to jaldi khatam हो जाते हैं, तो आई बाय इट एवरी टाइम एंड इट वर्क्स रियली वेल. नेक्स्ट वन इज द ऑर्डिनरी नायासिनामाइड. आई हैव ट्राइड अ लॉट ऑफ नायासिनामाइड, आई लॉट एट लीस्ट आई ट्राइड 3 to 4 or 5 टाइप्स ऑफ नायासिनामाइड, बट नथिंग वर्क्स लाइक द ऑर्डिनरी. आई एम एक्चुअली ट्राइंग द बी मिनरलिस्ट वन, सो आई डोंट हैव एन ओपिनियन ऑन दैट येट, बट दिस ऑर्डिनरी वन इज रियली ग्रेट इफ यू वॉन्ट अ सेफ अप्रोच फॉर योर एक्नी प्रोन स्किन, टू रेड्यूस ब्लेमिशेस, टू रेड्यूस एक्नी, टू ब्राइटन योर स्किन, हाइड्रेट योर स्किन, एवरीथिंग. आई थिंक ऑर्डिनरी नायासिनामाइड इज रियली गुड. आई ऑलवेज हैव यू नो स्टॉक ऑफ नायासिनामाइड. आई डोंट नो व्हाई व्हेन आई हैव टू फिल्म ओनली दिस पीपल मेक सो मच नॉइज. Again, one of my favorite, really worth it. It's a little expensive in India compared to the UK because of the shipping and all the extra charges, but it is worth it if you can get your hands on it. Then the next one is the LA Shield Physco sunscreen. Now I've spoken about this multiple times that I don't use chemical sunscreens. I always look for a really good physical sunscreen because my skin cannot take chemical sunscreen, like cannot, not even possible. I've searched for so many good physical sunscreens and I think I really found one. It is a zinc plus titanium dioxide physical sunscreen and leaves a little to none like white cast, very 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 minimal. Actually, if it's 5 minutes, 10 minutes later, you don't even see, you don't even feel like you're applying a sunscreen. It is SPF 50 or 40 or 50, I believe, and really good sunscreen. Then the next one is my absolute favorite. Again, I always reach towards this, even if I have the LA Shield one. But if I feel like my skin is reacting and not in a good phase, then I don't go for LA Shield and I go for Neutrogena one, because there is something in it. It just helps heal my skin. In fact, though it's a sunscreen, it helps heal my skin and I really like it. My skin doesn't get clogged because of it. It's a non-comedogenic sunscreen. The only drawback of it is that it is very, very like huge white cast. So usually when I vlog or something and you guys see me with that white cast, that's usually because of the sunscreen. But it's one of the really, really good ones and I really like it. Then the next one is the Earth Rhythm Cleansing Gel to Milk Cleansing Balms. So I've tried the Earth Rhythm older ones, which are more thicker, but compared to those, these are far, far more better and really, really nice. I've been really enjoying one. I actually have an empty already and I'm going to use the other one. It's really good, does the job really well. It doesn't have polyethylene. I believe that the plastic ingredient which usually is there in most of the cleansing balms, it doesn't have fragrance, it doesn't have alcohol, it doesn't have anything. It's really good. So if you're looking for a really good cleansing balm to just melt your makeup away, I think you like this one is a really good one. Then the next one I fell in love this year is the Tribe Concepts Daily Cleanser. I use this cleanser almost every single morning. It is one of my favorite. It is so gentle. It just cleanses my skin because it's not a foaming thing. It doesn't strip my skin. It just does, like, you know, the superior layer of cleansing for my skin whenever I need it, and it is so good. And the next one, this one is actually something I've started using recently and I am actually really enjoying this. So this is from Dr. Sheth, and I'm just trying to explore the brand now. Like, I've not tried a lot of products from them. I just have a couple of things which I'm trying, but this one I'm really enjoying. So this is the ABC Cleansing Gel. It's a really good cleansing gel if you're a beginner who is looking forward to, you know, stepping into chemical exfoliation. This would be a really good starter. You can use it every, like, alternate day, every 2-3 days in the night. Just cleanse your face. Of course, when there is chemical exfoliation actives in your face, you need to, you know, cleanse your skin for like 1 minute to 90 seconds, so that actually actives, help your skin, and, you know, actives actually act on your skin. So this is one something I really like. The next one is the Paula's Choice BHA. It is very good. It is really good if you are really acne prone skin, really oily skin, then definitely give this one a try. It just cleanses your pores and maintains your skin on a whole, especially because I wear makeup a lot. It's really important for me to put my, like, you know, deep cleanse my skin, cleanse my pores, or else there's going to be a lot of buildup and it's not going to be good. So I really like to use BHA in my everyday routine. I do this every alternate days because it's winter right now and my skin is not that oily. Salicylic acid tends to dry your skin out a little bit, so I use it every alternate days and it works really well. Being on the topic of BHA, one more BHA I really like is from Sugandha. So that BHA is a very mild BHA. I feel even if it's 2%, it doesn't act as well as the Sugandha one. So if you're somebody who just likes to maintain your skin, you don't have a lot of active break, you don't have any, like, issues on your skin, you just want something to just maintain your skin and cleanse your skin, you can go with the Sugandha BHA one, because it just, like, does that. But if you need some intense active of salicylic acid, then go for Paula's Choice. And the next one is the Fiducia Botanica Calm and Detox Mask. Now this one has a lot of clays in it, so you need to be very mindful. If you have dry skin, it can get a little drying. I use it once a week these days and it does the job really well. If you're really afraid of chemical exfoliation, but if you want something to just cleanse your skin, then you can go with this mask. It is really good, but you need to be mindful that it can tend to dry your skin out for that, you know, particular period of time, and should not overuse it because it has a lot of clays. So just use it as much as you need it. Then we just have two more favorites left. That is, one is the Beauty Co teeth whitening powder. I cannot even tell you how much this powder had helped me. I got this last year, but I never used it, and this year, actually since the past 6 months, I've started using it. If you have yellow stained teeth and you're like, you know, struggling to get rid of them, you should definitely try this powder. It helped me a lot. Like, my teeth are still a little yellow, but this did help a lot in reducing the stains on like the yellow cast stain on my teeth. I use this every day in the morning. I brush with it for 1 minute, then go in with my normal toothpaste and brush it and like cleanse everything, and it works really great for me. Last favorite of this year, I of course have a lot of favorites, you guys, but these are something I've been reaching out to a lot, and something I've been using almost every day, if not almost every day, every alternate day, every 2-3 days. And the one more thing is the Dot & Key AHA plus BHA chemical exfoliation one. The only con of this is the fragrance in it. I wish there was no fragrance in it, because when I have so many actives on my face, I wish they didn't have that fragrance part of it. But I've used it on my skin and I didn't react, but I still you know, want my that product to be fragrance free, because I don't want my skin to get sensitized to it. So it's a very good beginner chemical exfoliation product because it has 10% AHA and 2% BHA. The ordinary one is 30% and this is 10%, so it's like a more milder version. But this also, use it once in 10 days, once in 1 week, more than enough. They say once in 2 weeks, like twice in 1 week, but don't do that. I think once in 1 week is more than enough. AHA is very strong. They do have glycolic acid, everything, lactic acid, etc. So if you use chemical exfoliation in tiny bits, like in your cleanser, etc., on a daily basis or every other day, this, you don't need to use it every like 2 times in 1 week. You can just use it like once in 10 days and that would be good enough. Now, coming to the worst skincare of 2020. So the first one is the Eclat Vitamin C Serum. Now, I've tried this, my mom has tried this. My mom is not acne prone, okay? But she also broke out because of this. I don't know what is there in it. I've used it, and every time I used it, I used to sweat so much. And that means usually products which are really heavy for your skin usually make you sweat a lot. And it is really, I know a lot of people like it, but it did not work for me at all. I broke out so badly. I used to get this tiny comedone, like so many comedones every time I use it. So like, okay, it's not good for me, but my mom can use it. I gave it to my mom and the same thing happened with my mom as well. So I don't really like this product at all. And first of all, the fragrance in all these products is so, so strong. Now I'm like 50-50 on fragrance. Like if it's very, very minimal and very, very less, I'm fine with it. But if it's so overpowering, my mind just cannot accept to put it on my face. So the same thing, a lot of people rave about Fade Out as well, and I want to really try it. I did try it for 1 week, but the fragrance is so strong that my mind doesn't let me use that product. But anyway, I really like the under eye serum from them, but the vitamin C did not work for me at all. And I wish they, get with more like fragrance free products. I would really like to try products from them, but the fragrance is just too strong for my taste, and it's just me, and that's my opinion. The next one is the Sane Botanica sunscreen. So this sunscreen, vitamin C sunscreen, I've used this when I went to Andaman in March, and it was so bad. Now I know it's a chemical sunscreen and it doesn't suit me, that this one was the worst among all. It made me break out so badly, like literally my entire face. Like I got 5-6 one time I used, and it's like 5-6 the whole of my trip. I had to like, just deal with those pimples in all my pictures, all my videos, and that was very annoying, and I do not like it at all, like not even a little bit. Then the next one is this face mask from Mama Earth. So I thought it will be really nice, and I got it because the ingredients seem fine, everything, but I think the peppermint is something very tingling on the skin, and I couldn't keep it on my skin for longer. I tried it twice and the same thing happened, and I could not, like, it did not suit my skin. It started burning, it started irritating, and it did not suit my skin at all. Then the next one is the Dermacore Niacinamide. Now, actually, I forgot to mention one of my favorites from Dermacore. It is the sunscreen. I do really like their mineral sunscreen as well. They are coming out with fragrance-free products next year, so I'm really excited about that. But coming to this one, this is their Dermacore Niacinamide. Now, the same issue with me is the fragrance. Like, if the fragrance is at least the last ingredient, I don't really mind. The AHA, BHA gel, etc., they have, like, in the last, so I'm like, okay, I'm trying it. But in the Niacinamide, it's literally the fifth or sixth ingredient in between the list. It is so, the smell is so strong and is so, overpowering. I used it a couple of times and my skin did not like it. It did not accept the serum at all. And putting fragrance aside also, I've tried that serum for more than like 10 to 15 days and my skin did, like, had no use of it. It reacted, in fact, it was not doing well. It had like a lot of small tiny bumps which came into place, and it could be because of the fragrance, it could not be because of some other ingredient, but it did not suit my skin at all. Then the next one is Earth Rhythm Sun Defense Sunscreen. So this one, when I initially used it, I really liked it because it leaves like no white cast at all, and I was like, oh, that is really nice, I'm impressed, like, there's no white cast, it's a mineral sunscreen, it doesn't have any chemical ingredients in it. I was like, okay, wow, impressed. But when I started using it every day, it kind of became really heavy for my skin and it started becoming really comedogenic. So I would really recommend this sunscreen if you have dry skin or normal skin combination and oily skin. The sunscreen would be really heavy and might tend to like clog your pores. Combination or oily skin, then avoid this one because it can get really heavy. So yeah guys, that's it for the video. These are the products which worked for me and did not work for me. I hope you enjoyed this video. Then if you did, then make sure like, share and subscribe to my channel and wait for my next video, which is going to be the best and worst of makeup. I have a lot to say about makeup, and stay tuned for that. So yeah, actually this is the last video for this year. So yeah, I guess I'll see you next year. Bye.